Right, good evening. Thank you for being here. My name's Mac Benzon. I am the Deputy Chief of Operations for the Reno Police Department. I'd like to take an opportunity to introduce those that are present today. Reno Police Chief Jason Soto, Reno City Attorney Carl Hall, Supervisory Special Agent from the FBI, Rob Bowles, Commander Mark Catry, and then Commander Oliver Miller. Today's press briefing is being held to provide the community with a factual update of the ongoing investigation into the incident that occurred Monday evening near the Reno Arch. Chief Soto will provide you with a timeline of events as they unfolded Monday evening and a general update on the investigation. Because this is still an ongoing criminal investigation, Chief Soto, City Attorney Hall, and the other folks present here will not be taking any questions regarding the case. I'd like to introduce Chief Soto.
Thank you, Chief Benzon. Good evening, Chief Soto of the Reno Police Department. Thank you all for being here tonight. I will be giving an update regarding the event that occurred on October 10th, 2016, near the Reno Arch. I would first like to emphasize that the majority of the individual demonstrators present were peaceful in their march. The investigation thus far has identified that some of the combative and aggressive individuals in the demonstrators group were not part of the original group who gathered to peacefully protest in the plaza. There were individuals who were in the area of the arch and chose to become involved in the incident with the vehicle. I would like to thank those individuals who gathered peacefully to express their views and beliefs. I'm going to give you a factual timeline of events that occurred after dozens of interviews of witnesses and the methodical review of multiple videos that have surfaced since the time of the incident. I understand that this investigation is a priority to the community and that it must be investigated thoroughly. It is our desire to be transparent to our community while protecting the rights of all individuals involved in accordance with our laws. On October 10, 2016, at approximately 6:41 p.m., Reno Police Department received multiple reports of an incident involving demonstrators and a vehicle near the area of Virginia Street Reno Arch in downtown Reno. One of the callers identified himself as the driver of the involved truck, 18-year-old Nick Mahappy, who was with the 17-year-old passenger at the time of the incident. During this contact, Mr. Mahaffey and his passenger indicated they were the victim of a battery while seated in the vehicle near the Reno Arch, which caused him to drive through the crowd to avoid being seriously injured. After reaching an area of safety away from the demonstrators, approximately 1 minute after the incident, Mr. Mahaffey called 911 to report the incident. Within a minute of the first 911 call, officers arrived in the area of the arch and contacted several individuals who reported a vehicle, later confirmed to be the vehicle operated by Mr. Mahaffey, had driven through the demonstrators in the roadway. Paramedics also arrived on scene and transported a 59-year-old female to Reno for injuries sustained as a result of this incident. In addition, other individuals were treated on scene by paramedics for minor injuries. Circumstances were initially unclear as to what specifically had occurred, and the Reno Police Department initiated a criminal investigation into the incident. That investigation was later assigned to the Robbery Homicide Division. The resulting investigation revealed that a peaceful protest was scheduled for the downtown plaza across from City Hall, where the group would demonstrate against the Dakota Access Pipeline and advocate for a change to the name of the Columbus Day holiday to the Indigenous People Day. That demonstration occurred for approximately 1 to 1.5 hours before the group marched to the Reno Arch, about 3 blocks north of City Hall. Mr. Mahaffey and his juvenile passenger had attended a portion of the peaceful protest. During the march to the arch, beginning in the 200 block of North Virginia Street, some of the participants in the demonstrating group began walking in the northbound lane of Virginia Street, disrupting traffic and causing vehicles to enter the center lane and or southbound Virginia Street lanes. Some of the vehicles, which were forced to drive around the demonstrators, are heard honking their horns. Some of the demonstrators walking in the street posted video expressing their disregard for the flow of traffic. As the demonstrators walked north in the 200 block of North Virginia Street, blocking the northbound lanes, Mr. Mahaffey's truck is observed traveling south in the southbound lanes. Words are exchanged with the demonstrators. The entirety of this exchange was not captured on video that has been available to RPD. However, Mr. Mahaffey is recorded saying expletives, and Mr. Mahaffey does not stop during this exchange and continues past the group. The group of demonstrators from the plaza and several subjects who joined the march along the way gathered under the Reno Arch for approximately 2 minutes. After several photographs are taken, the group remains under the arch, and a female is heard advocating why there should be a change to the holiday name with the assistance of an amplified sound device. Although some members of the group expressed to investigators they had intended only to take a photograph under the arch, another participant reported that the plan was to occupy and block Virginia Street under the arch for 2 hours. Approximately 2.5 minutes later, after Mr. Mahaffey is seen exchanging words with the walking demonstrators in the 200 block of North Virginia Street, Mr. Mahaffey is observed traveling south on Virginia Street from Plaza Street. The demonstrators were in the roadway blocking North Virginia Street in both directions. Mr. Mahaffey approached in an antagonistic manner, revving his engine and repeatedly honking his horn. Some of this behavior is readily visible on the video, which have been posted on various social media sites. Mr. Mahaffey's vehicle is approached by several individuals. Some of those individuals can be heard telling Mr. Mahaffey to take a different route, while others are heard making threats to remove him from his vehicle and or to perform acts of violence upon him. A verbal altercation involving Mr. Mahaffey, his passenger, and several individuals on the side of the vehicle ensued. During the verbal exchange, there are no recorded statements of any of the videos which have been collected and reviewed where any reference to race or religion is made by any of the parties involved in this incident. Mr. James Fletcher is observed attempting to open Mr. Mahaffey's driver door. Moments later, Mr. Fletcher is captured on several videos punching Mr. Mahaffey in the face. The punch is corroborated by independent witnesses, members of the demonstrators, and Mr. Mahaffey. At this time, Mr. Mahaffey lurched his vehicle forward into a group of demonstrators who had been standing in front of the vehicle. Mr. Mahaffey, who has participated in an interview with the investigators, explained he feared for his safety based on the threats and acts of violence. Mr. Mahaffey explained that he hoped the lurch forward would encourage demonstrators to move so he could flee the area before being seriously injured. As Mr. Mahaffey's vehicle moves forward, Mr. Samuel Harry is captured on video punching the 17-year-old passenger of Mr. Mahaffey's vehicle in the face. When Mr. Mahaffey's vehicle stops, he is struck additional times. Video depicts a female jamming a wooden stick into Mr. Mahaffey's driver's side window. Mr. Mahaffey explained people were attempting to pull him out of his vehicle, fearing serious injury to him and his passenger. He lurched forward to encourage demonstrators to clear a path. Mr. Mahaffey then accelerated out of the area. Mr. Mahaffey sustained minor injuries consistent with his rendition of the incident. There have been several questions as to whether or not either of the individuals in the vehicle were struck. When you watch these videos, it's very difficult to follow because they're moving very quickly. After combing through all of these videos, we are going to share with you a few still images that we've taken from some of these tapes that we have. This is number one. It's kind of difficult to see, but what you see is his face and his arm of the individual striking Mr. Mahaffey in the face. That's the first one. You want to go to the second one? This is a picture of the individual, the passenger. You can see with his arm inside the vehicle striking the passenger in the face. We've also attained some additional video that you haven't seen on social media that we're going to share with you that's a little bit more clear. We'll probably play it two or three times just so that you can see it. This is just obtained in the last 24 hours, so I don't believe it's been available to the public at all. It's very quick. Right there. Go back. See the individual at the passenger, the driver's side door. See him striking the individual inside the vehicle. So we felt it was important to share that with our community, to be transparent in this entire investigation. Now this investigation is ongoing, as was stated earlier. However, the facts and circumstances that have become apparent have resulted in probable cause to believe a crime was committed for at least three individuals. Reports have been presented to the city attorney, Carl Hall, requesting warrants to be issued for Mr. Nick Mahaffey for provoking an assault, Mr. James Fletcher for simple battery, and Mr. Samuel Harry for simple battery. The Honorable Judge Ken Howard authorized the issuance of those warrants this afternoon. There have been insinuations that this is a hate crime by several members of our community. The FBI is aware of this incident, and we are in regular communication with the local office of the FBI. If during the course of this ongoing investigation, any information is developed that suggests that a federal civil rights violation has occurred, the FBI has informed us that they are prepared to investigate. We would like to express our thanks to Reno City Attorney Carl Hall for his assistance with this investigation. As this is an ongoing investigation, we would appreciate if anybody with information about this incident contact the Reno Police Department or secret witness. This case is now being turned over to our city attorney, Mr. Carl Hall's office. Thank you.
So Chief, with the evidence you have, are you saying that race is not involved?
I'm only going to conclude with a quick statement because it's the obvious question. As we speak, the robbery homicide detectives are attempting to contact those with the issued warrants to arrange their surrender for arrest. Once that's done, and once we have more updates and additional information becomes available, we'll continue to update the community on that additional information. Thank you for joining us, and thanks for coming out. Appreciate it.